Now text www.dsb.wa.gov 1-800-552-7103. A title appears, Employment. Images of people and text of various job titles.
I work as a senior human resources analyst for King County.
I am a telephone operator for McCord Air Force Base.
I work as an assistive technology specialist.
I work for the Puget Sound Community Health Center.
President of the Lighthouse for the Blind.
Master Data Management Developer.
I am a vocational rehabilitation counselor.
Public relations assistant.
And I'm a speech and language assistant.
I'm a civil rights attorney.
I currently work in internal audit.
Sales and marketing.
I am a sales associate.
I'm a marketer.
I'm an accounts payable clerk.
I am so happy to have my job, and I think I'm a positive force in the workplace.
Throughout, images of people, adaptive equipment, and workspaces. Text, Mike.
As an MDM developer, I'm responsible for developing solutions that relates to master data management within the BIS component here at Weyerhaeuser. They employed me and immediately got me into a program with the Department of Services for the Blind that identifies special needs as far as being able to still continuously do my job although I have a disability. And Weyerhaeuser actually committed on the job time for this program to be solicited.
Text, Noelle Nightingale.
As a blind attorney, I need to have many skills in my tool belt that I can use at any particular time, depending on what the task is. I use Braille when I'm interviewing people. I take notes on a laptop or some kind of note-taking device. I use my white cane to travel to the places where I need to go to conduct investigations if that's what I'm doing. Employers should consider hiring a blind person because they bring intangible assets to the workplace that other people who haven't had to confront the kinds of problems that we confront have had to deal with.
Text. More job titles appear and move off screen. Text. Kirk Adams.
The Lighthouse is a social enterprise. About 90% of our revenues come from earned income, primarily through manufacturing and the operation of base service centers located on 4 military bases. Last year, we managed about $37.5 million in sales. I have been hired by the board as the top executive paid staff person to make sure that we are doing what all good employers should be doing, and that's developing each individual as a person and as part of the organization. As an employer seeking to put together an effective workforce, I think a great strategy is to look at those parts of the population that have been underemployed. And if you look at people who are blind, you will see a group that can show successful examples of blind people performing all kinds of job functions with the right training, the right tools, and the right blindness skills. More and more employers will be looking toward underemployed groups like people who are blind. And I think it would behoove any employer to be ahead of that curve, to start learning how to hire, recruit, train, and retain people who are blind.
More job titles appear and move off screen. Text, Sue Porter.
An employer can hire Services for the Blind directly for low vision services and talk about how well they feel that this particular solution works or doesn't work, how it might need to be modified or improved, or give feedback, this is great, now I'm confident that my employee is able to do whatever the job task is.
They also actually took the recommendations out of this program for special accessibility tools that can be used in the environment for me to accomplish all the different tasks and goals that I have.
Text, Naomi Namakata.
Usually the employer is very surprised at what a wide range of devices are available to someone who is low vision or blind. We work with employers and provide assessment services to determine what kinds of accommodations an employee might need on the job to perform their job functions.
And then we still write up recommendations and provide very, very specific ordering information.
Employers should understand that although, you know, you're hiring a blind person, you're hiring a person.
People make assumptions about blind people.
Just ask. Ask about blindness, ask about adaptive technology.
Don't start making assumptions about what that person can or can't do.
Just ask.
Never make an assumption.
Never assume what the abilities of a person with a disability would have.
I may be blind, but my blindness certainly doesn't prevent me from doing my job.
If a person is qualified, and that person knows his or her qualifications, they bring with them the tools necessary to perform their job.
If you can focus on the qualifications and the strengths and the education and the experience, then the blindness should not be a factor.
I'm visually impaired, but I am still a functional human being.
I can stay a productive member of society.
I'm 100% dedicated.
I'm not giving up.
I'm equal.
I'm not less.
I know I can do it.
We are capable.
I can do a job.
I'm no different than any other person.
An employer should hire a blind guy because we're fun.
Now text www.dsb.wa.gov 1-800-552-7103.